I pray that the fire will come back again.
Amen.
I say I pray that the fire will come back again.
Amen.
What our fathers touched, may somebody touch in this generation.
Amen.
I say what our fathers touched, may somebody touch in this generation. Lakini haitakuja tukikaa kama retire these people who are Israel. Tawe ina celebrating anniversaries. Look at your age and what you are celebrating. 10 years of God's faithfulness. What have we done? You need to repent. Spirit of feeling like you have arrived. You don't want to learn. You just want to hold on the few little things that you have been taught by people who are ignorant. They only have information and no experience. They will criticize every move of God, but they cannot move God. Their work is knowledge, books, material, notes. How many people have been healed by notes? How many deaths have been raised by notes? Now, too much English without the power of God. And I know you know what I'm talking about. Don't pretend that you don't know. You know what I'm talking about. Nimekuja kuwachokoza. Waka moto. Wale wakukaa kando wakae kando. Choma. Weka hiyo information kwa kichwa. Na roho ichomeke. Let your heart be hot. Let your heart be on fire. That when you produce the same scriptures, it will come out like fire.
Amen.
Am I speaking to somebody here? Is there somebody here ready for revival?
Yes.
Is somebody here ready for revival?
Yes.
Someone lift up your hand and shout hallelujah. I rebuke every spirit of retirement and anniversaries. What are you celebrating? No creep has walked, no deaf ears heard, no demon has gone, and you are celebrating what God has done. What has God done? Still dating girls right, left, and center. What has God done? Created the girls for you.
Hallelujah.
After every 2 months, you have a new girlfriend, you have a new boyfriend. Who are you? What are you? Are you studying humanology or something? What are you doing? You know, God has said, ninakata. Sema kwa sauti ninakata. Ninakata kucheza na injili.
Ninakata.
Sema amen.
Amen.
Sema amen. I see fire coming to the
church.
And brethren, if you are not ready, the younger ones will take the mantle. We will learn from our juniors if we don't take it serious. I pray that it will not bypass us. That's why I'm preaching in high schools, I'm preaching in colleges, and men, by the grace of God, I'm pastoring 2 churches. By the grace of God. But I'm still leaving those churches. Go to high schools. Go to colleges, meeting form ones, and I've seen them receiving the Holy Spirit with a hunger and eagerness. Ask my brothers here. They have been with me there. They have seen. We went to a school. I will not tell you which one. Go to high school, you will see it. I went to a school to preach. I came back home, I could not sleep. I found boys that are hungry for God. Boys! Mbaga saya kutoa sadaka wanatoa wakiongea na dini. I looked at them, and when I stood up to preach, the heavens were open. I knew if I don't have a message, they will preach to me. I don't know if I've sinned, forgive me now. I preach, I minister, they were filled. I don't say they got filled with the Holy Spirit. I want to say they were taken to another level because they were already filled.
Yes.
I was challenged when I came back home. When I came back home, I arrived at home at around midnight or 1 a.m. Mm. I could not sleep until 3:30. I had to pray until morning. I told God, how can boys have a revelation that I don't have?
You see, my hope, according to Hebrew, according to Bible math,
some of you are studying even Bible math. Have you studied your own math?
Amen.
Let's go back to Fatherhood. Marks of a true father. One,
A true father is a follower of Christ.
We have so many people in our generation acting like fathers, but they are not following Christ. I know you know where Paul says, should be 1 Corinthians 11 verse 1, follow me as I follow who? Be imitators of me as I imitate who? Christ is the standard. No matter how great a man of God is, the moment they stop talking about God and begin talking about themselves, run away from them. Keep off. Amen?
Amen.
Amen?
Amen.
I'm saying amen?
Amen.
No matter how powerful you are, you cannot be more powerful than God. No matter how holy you are, you cannot be holier than the Holy Ghost. Somebody shout amen.
Amen.
Somebody shout amen.
Amen.
Say a follower of Christ.
Follower of Christ.
A true spiritual father is a follower of Christ. Follow me as I follow Christ. There are great men of God who veered from the truth because they stopped following Christ. Don't follow anybody who doesn't point you to Christ. Number two, they point people to Christ. Christ is center. John 1:29. Behold the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. John pointed people to Christ. Christ was the center. Even when they tried to tell him, are you the Messiah? Are you this? Are you this? He said, no. There is one coming after me. No matter how much people were wooed into his ministry, how much people admired his ministry, he still told them that there is the Christ. Any man that points himself is a liar. He's not a father. He's not a man of God. Somebody shout amen.
Amen.
Amen. Lay down your crowns. Work at him. As soon as you receive it, put it down. In honor of Brenda Moyes, when I put my paper, I will come back and say, I'm child. Now, if you want a paper, you may talk about CGPK before. Lay down your crowns. If you want God to use you, sometimes in the mission, there is what we call communal anointing. And it may favor you. You may be the one in that crusade. And because there is a corporate anointing, things happen. Please, usijipige kifua. Nyenyekea. Na ukubali Mungu ajue ya kwamba, kama sio yeye, haungefanya lolote. Sema amen.
Amen.
And you know the way people would love to come and greet you, hey, man of God, you have done powerfully. Unasikia, ndani unasikia ukiwa ka king, lakini unajifanya I am humble. But you know that I am humble is actually coming with a lot of pride. Do you understand what I'm saying? Do you understand what I'm saying?
Yes.
I have been there. There is a time in my infancy ministry, whenever I preached and nobody told me, you have really touched me, I felt offended. I felt like I've not delivered. Na hata unatafuta mtu unamwambia, unasikia hiyo? Nilikuwa. Hizo kwa mzamusha unasikia aje. That's what the church means. Wanasikua sana. And what you are looking for is the praises of men. Because of pride. You begin to point people to yourself. And whenever you feel like God has used you, go back. Don't even go to the Bible. Look at people God is using around you. More powerful than you. Na unyenyekee. Look at many. Look at Bishop Oyedepo. Look at Smith Wigglesworth. How he was used by God. Look at Bishop Light. Look at them. They are here in Kenya. I know even if you hate one, you may not hate all of them. At least among those I have mentioned, you can look at one. Look at them. Na unyenyeke. Ukienda kufanya mkutano kwa kijiji yako, watu 15 wakuje. Uanze kusema mlikuwa mmejaa kwa room ya 10 by 10. Remember someone is doing a meeting in a 3 kilometer by 3 kilometer auditorium. Are you with me?
Yes.
I'm saying, are you with me?
Yes.
Ukienda wewe kusema uhubiri upige nduru because your relatives are there. There is a lot of amen because it's your village and it's your relatives. And you know it's your cousins that are shouting amen. Even when you are not saying hallelujah. Usidhanie ni wewe na usijipige kifua. Sema amen usikie.
Amen.
Sema amen.
Amen.
Point people to Christ. Because I believe God is also raising fathers out of here.
Amen.
And voices out of here.
Amen.
Fathers think generationally. Anybody who thinks now is not, does not have a father spirit. That's why a father will do anything to invest in a son. They'll go an extra mile to invest in a son. They think generationally. Fathers think generationally. Before Jacob died, he was concerned about his biological children. He talked about their destiny. He talked about their future. Actually, for your information, fathers are not concerned with your past. They are more concerned with your future. They think generationally. Marks of a true father. A father practices enviable lifestyle. I'll send you to read John chapter 5, 19 downwards. Jesus says, I do what I see my father do. A father is visible and practices emulatable character. Look at this. A teacher will tell you, do this. A father will tell you, do what I am doing. You see the difference? A teacher can instruct you. A father will give you a lifestyle. Jesus said, I do what I see my father do. A father practices an emulatable lifestyle. A father is loving. A father is loving. A father instructs. Throughout the book of Proverbs, listen to me, my son. Listen to me, my son. Listen to the instruction. Listen to me, my son. Listen to me, my son. There's something deeper there that I don't want to go into. But a father is an instructor. Instructions are more than just teaching. How to identify a spiritual father? Let me just talk about, because of time, how to honor a father. We'll talk about identifying a spiritual father later. I don't want to touch things and leave them hanging. How to honor a father? Malachi chapter 1 verse 6. If I am your father, where is my honor? So a father deserves honor. Ephesians chapter 6. Children, obey your parents in the Lord. Honor thy father and mother, so that it may be well with you, and so that you may live long on earth. A preacher invited one time has written a book called The Fifth Commandment about honor your father and mother, and he says that long life is not a prayer item. Long life is a responsibility. Mm. It is about honor. Mm. No matter how much you dishonor, no matter how much you pray and dishonor your father, biological, spiritual, you are cutting your life short. Mm. Proverbs says that the eye that dishonors a father, it will be better for eagles, for vultures, to come and pluck it out. So once you dishonor a father, you lack vision, you lack a future. Can I surprise you that a man by the name Absalom dishonored his father? Even nature itself dishonored him. What was his strength in life? The Bible talks about his long hair, that was better than any Israelite. The Bible says that when he was running away from Joab, was it Joab? The trees arrested the hair. His beauty became his downfall. Even nature said, you cannot live. And the Bible says he built a monument for himself because he did not have descendants. You cannot dishonor fathers and have descendants. You cannot have offsprings. You are cut off. You don't have roots. You cannot have fruits. Am I speaking to somebody here? Mm. When you destroy your roots, you cannot have fruits. So be careful. There's a message that I call, maybe one time, God help me, I'll share with you, that I call the weaknesses and the wickedness of a father and the wisdom of a son. The weaknesses, the wickedness of a father and the wisdom of a son. Every father has weaknesses. Some fathers are wicked. Some fathers are wicked. But it is in wisdom to honor a father for a son, no matter who they are. Remember, Noah was coming from a hangover. But whatever he pronounced, heaven honored. Jacob had a bad history. But whatever he said, even whatever he said about the tribe of Reuben, you shall not excel. You shall not excel. You shall be as unstable as waters. Genesis 49. It is what manifests. The only two guys that tried to rise in the tribe of Reuben rose up, and the words of their father spoke against them. They rebelled against Moses, and the ground swallowed them. They were Reubenites. No priest, no prophet, no important person ever came from that lineage. I used to say that in chapter 33 of Deuteronomy, Moses stood up as a spiritual father and broke the curse. But I came to realize, no, what Moses did was just an intercession. He interceded for them. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Why? Jacob was higher in ranking than Moses. When God called Moses, he told him, I am the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. So Moses was submitting to the God of Jacob. Jacob was actually Moses' father. Jacob was a spiritual and a physical father. You remember the Bible says that Jacob, gather to me, sons of Jacob, and listen to your father Israel. Israel presented the spiritual side of him. Jacob presented the biological or the natural part of him. So Moses could not break the curse. He only interceded and said, let Reuben live and his descendants not be few. But he could not break the curse. The man was higher than him in ranking. Never provoke a father. And I'm trying to say that fathers can be weak. Fathers can be stammerers. Fathers can be weak. Samuel knew all the weaknesses of Saul, but he still called him my father. He knew the man is rejected. Never play with anybody that played a spiritual role in your life, no matter how weak and wicked they have become. It's not your work to use them as manure. If you turn your roots to manure, you will never rise. Your roots must remain your roots. Are you getting what I'm saying?
Yes.
That's why there's a lot of spiritual disorder in the church. People do what they think to go where they want to go, ordain themselves. You go this way and come back as an apostle. You go this way, come back as a prophetic usher. You go this way, come back as an evangelistic, you know, security. You go this way, you come as a worshiping evangelist. You know, powerful titles. Unasikia mwingine, I am a pastor with an apostolic calling, but my prophetic gift is very dominant. But the apostolic calling is highly, there is grace for that. And my teaching ministry is unique, and I'm an evangelist officially. And recently I became an archbishop of evangelists. And you know, titles, lack of fatherhood brings problems of identity. Speak of a minister. Absence of fatherhood, because fathers name their sons. When you name yourself, you make mistakes. Napata mtu hapa anajiita apostle, and heaven even calls you a new believer. Heaven calls you a new believer. Nakwapo kisema an apostle. The other day we went to a nice school, and a student told us, go and greet Pastor so-and-so, tell him the apostle of Msalini. I said, what? So I was preaching to men of God. Told him it's a privilege to meet you, sir. So, titles, because lack of identity is a problem of fatherhood. Fathers give names. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. That's what I call what a father carries, a name. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. A father has a kingdom. Thy will be done. A father has a will, as it is in heaven, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Our Father carries provision, and forgive us our sins, compassion. For thine is the kingdom, jurisdiction, the power and the glory. Power and glory, a father carries. Forever and ever, longevity is tied to fatherhood. I've summarized a message that I can preach for 1 hour from the Lord's Prayer. Praise the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Say amen.
Amen.
Say amen.
Amen.
Ask your neighbor, you are saying amen like an apostle. Shout aloud, amen.
Amen.
I'm going to give you maybe 4 ways of honoring a father, and then we wind up. I don't want to take much of your time. I know some of you are going to cook eggs. Amen. And Indomie. Hallelujah. One day God will deliver you from that. What is for honor? Say amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I remember those days. Na kuna wengine tulikuwa tunapika na coil, saa zingine stima inaenda. Ikirudi saa 8 unasikia ugali ikinuka. They must make sure that supper amekula. Nataki kuingia na program ati overlap na breakfast. Unasikia wanaona ugali inanuka saa 8. Kumbe ni stima imerudi. Bwana asifiwe sana. Some people are serious with life. They read that scripture that says everything should be done in order. Breakfast cannot overlap with supper. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 Praise the name of Jesus.
Amen.
It's a wonderful experience to be a student. And especially here. You guys don't even need to pray for the fruit of patience. You know, I preached here for some time, Jenga. Praise the Lord.
some people, I've seen some people here for quite some time. Doctors, you study for 7 years, 6 years. Wow. We need to come here and receive an impartation of patience. 4 years for me was a hell. I was actually in school for 1 week, away for 2 weeks. Only exams kept me in school. Nilikuwa na miss shule mpaka my classmates wakiniona wananiuliza kwani hakuna mission. I was a full-time mission and a part-time student. But I advise you not to behave that way. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. So what is to honor? To honor is to esteem, is to speak well of, is to inspire. To honor is to esteem. So you honor by esteeming. To honor is to speak well of. If you speak evil against your father, that's not your father. He's a lie, it cannot help him. Look at this. David knew that Saul had a demon, but he never said it anywhere. Have you ever heard anywhere David saying, and I casted a demon out of my father Saul? Never. In the case of Noah, look, David knew that he knows his father has a demon because the father has brought him close to him. It is actually a privilege to know a demon in your family. Should you give an offering for that you are entrusted with his weakness? For Noah, one of the sons came and laughed about his nakedness. The other one covered. Literally speaking, that's speaking well of him. That's covering his weaknesses. I love saying that father's nakedness are not for coverage, but for covering. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
To inspire. Do you inspire? You honor a man of God or a father in your life or a father figure by inspiring them. Look, even your pastor, just an ordinary man of God, learn to say amen in a service. Don't be the person that will make the pastor doubt whether he's called. Usikuwa ni unafanya mtu mpaka anajiuliza na nimeitwa kweli. Nimeitwa kweli ama nimejiita. There are people who are so hard in church, hata ukiwa na point hawaandiki. Hawaandiki. Generally in this way. Whenever your father is speaking right notes, and not just your father, any pastor that comes here, inspire them. Sini wewe umemwita? Hata kama yuko sasa, sini nyinyi umemwita? Andika notes. Say my amen, encourage them, inspire them. Once I talk up and scare, my calling is validated. Become an encourager to others. And not just a pastor, even the programmer or somebody else. Become an encourager.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Even with that, you are still struggling to say amen. I refuse to allow you to make me feel like I am not called. Not called, ya baridi kuitwa. To encourage, to honor is to encourage. 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 And I want to tell you a secret. After a man has preached to you, and I'm not saying that if you come to tell me now, I know that is hypocritical. After a man has preached, go and tell them, thank you. You have blessed my life. Encourage them. Wacha kwenda ukisema, there is a man of God that spoke something in my life. You have not encouraged that person and you go, you know, giving testimonies there to people who are not even listening. To honor is to brag about, is to brag of. The people that I have mentioned here, I have bragged about their achievements. I am honoring them. They may not be here, but in the spirit realm, it is recorded that I have honored them. Somebody shout amen.
Amen.
Somebody shout amen.
Amen.
Don't be so quick to, and I'm not talking about these controversial people who have, I'm not talking about people that have erred in doctrine. And I'm not saying don't stand firm on doctrinal issues. I know like here in Kenya we have a lot of nonsense on the pulpit. I'm not saying that now we have said honor fathers, akiuza mafuta unanunua unamuencourage, akiuza kifagio unamuinspire, akiuza sijui nini unamuesteem, bwana asifiwe sana. Usiwe usiwe mpaka mende. Appreciate. To honor is to appreciate. To honor is to recognize. Let me give you a secret. Young men and ladies that go around preaching in churches. When you go to a church,
honor the father of that house. Ukienda kwa kanisa, you are under the father of that house. Honor that father. Siende hapo ukisema, today is the day. When was this church founded? 2010. This is a joke. There is something you have been waiting for 9 years. Today it has come. Somebody has been there for 9 years and that's why you have come there. Sema amen. Sema amen. Wacha kwenda na kifua na panana mingi sana. Ndio maana huko kitu tena mahali ulienda. Nataka mahali utaenda next week tena. Sema
amen.
Before you start talking, encourage that man. And make the people know that no matter how powerful I am, I'm not the father of this house. This man or this woman is the father of his house.
Yes.
That's a secret that will help you. Say amen.
Amen.
Unahubiri hapo. Natokea hapo mpaka unatumia examples funny funny na the man. Unasema, pastor, come. Can you squat here? I want to demonstrate the spirit of a frog. Unaona pastor ruka. Na pastor anaruka na mchezo. Unaruka kwa pastor. Ruka mzuri. Once I'm here the easy missions, the campus, sometimes I don't like what campus students go and do. Some of them go and mess churches. Wanaenda wanaacha wameibisha pastor mbele ya washirika wake. Mama anambia pastor hizi mara ngapi umeenda kwa madhabahu? Do you know what that color means? That's the color of a funeral. Bwana asifiwe sana. Na by the time you are leaving, the church is in a mess. Bwana Yesu asifiwe sana.
Amen.
Unaambia pastor alale chini kwa floor demonstrate kitu. The father of that house. Na unamkanyaga kanyaga hapa nyuma. When the anointing comes, it's like power. God forbid. If you do that in our church, the ushers will take care of me. Bwana Yesu asifiwe sana.
Amen.
When I was talking about fathers beyond your specific spiritual father, that's what I'm talking about. When I come to your local church, I will honor your pastor, even if I'm more anointed than him. Yeah? Even if I preach, I speak better English than him. He is a custodian of that house. I'm under him. He may be younger than me, but he is the father of that house. Sema
amen.
Wewe ukienda kuhubiri kwa makanisa, hata uintroduciwe aje, umetoka university, umetoka wapi, hata toka binguni, honor is key. Whatever you appreciate in your life. Say amen.
Amen.
By loving them. Love your father, you know. Read about love in 1 Corinthians chapter 13. Love is patient. Be patient with them. Love is long suffering. Bear with some hard issues. Sometimes they make things hard now because they can see your future. Yeah? What else about love? Does not keep records of wrong. Some of you even have a book of the mistakes of my father. Umeandika kuna siku aliniangalia vibaya, kuna siku aliniongelesha vibaya, kuna siku aliniintroduce to hivi hivi akasema kuja, Matthew, come. He never recognized the anointing in me. Na ukasimama ukaambia kanisa, the day you will know who is here. Bako unajifanya uko prophetic. Israel, Israel. You are missing the hour of your visitation. Oh, Gebomori, Gebomori. You can sound very prophetic, but the truth is that just right. God help you. Giving to fathers is very important. It's very important. The subject of giving is very controversial. People speak a lot of things, a lot of nonsense. If I teach you about giving, you will change your theology about giving. And I want you to know that the chief giver is God. And when you give, you don't give alms to your father. You don't give your father to lift him. You give your father to tap into the grace. Sometimes a father may be discouraged, but what, I'm not giving beyond money. Giving your time, giving your talent, giving your gift. Don't collect money when playing keyboard for your pastor or for your father. Don't collect money.
One time I was called by somebody in the league of a spiritual authority. And I didn't like what the person told me. Actually, I got irritated, and the more the person talked, the more judged I was. But as I left, I fueled the person's cup. I knew how to deal with myself is to release a seed. Whatever happened was so bad for me. It offended me. But I told myself, you are not dealing with your ego. I got into my pocket and begged to fuel the car. We are not trained very easily. The Holy Ghost does crazy things for us. Sometimes you apologize for being right. You know the person is wrong, but you apologize. Say, I am sorry. Never make your father kneel down, even your biological father. Ati babako anakupigia magoti, unamwambia, kama umerealize makosa yako dadina. Mimi nimekusamea. Enda na usifanye hiyo kazi tena. Ati mamako anakupigia magoti, tafadhali daktari. Unamwambia mamu. Mamu nimekusamea, lakini mimi hiyo kitu ikirudiwa tena. Hiyo mahali, no, please. You should actually kneel under this carpet. Huh? What has your son? Am I helping you?
Oh, yes.
I'm releasing wisdom for your destiny.
Oh, yes.
This will help you in life. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Genesis 45:27. After Joseph, evidence that you are alive is what you give. Anything alive produces. What Joseph did to his father, Joseph sent cats that were carrying food to his father. And the Bible says, when Jacob saw the cats, his spirit was revived. What you release can revive a broken father. And what you give to your father is for your lifting. I want to show you something that Paul talks about in Philippians chapter 4. Yeah, thank you. Philippians chapter 4 from verse 17. Can we read Philippians chapter 4 from verse 17? It is self-explanatory. I'm finding out. Not that I seek the gift. Look. Paul is talking about giving. He's collecting money from these people or gifts. But he's saying, not that I desire the gift, but I seek the fruit that abounds to your account. Continue. That what you are giving me is abiding in your accounts. Indeed, I have all and about, am full, happy received from ignore it. The king said to me, a sweet smelling aroma, an acceptable sacrifice, well pleasing to God. Continue. And my God shall supply. There is a message I preach. God gave me, I call it the God of my Father. The God of my Father.